I love coats. There is nothing, seriously, like anytime I'm watching a movie or a TV show or even just walking down the street and I see a nice coat, I'm like, I have like an emotional reaction to coats. Maybe it's because I live in Canada and coats are a necessity to existence, but I also just think from a style perspective, they really elevate outfits unlike any other accessory. There's just something so iconic about a nice classic trench coat or a trendy pea coat or even an edgy puffer coat. My name is Lisa Gabrielle and I make videos on fashion and lifestyle. So make sure to hit that subscribe button because I upload videos every week and I would love for you to join the family. So if you haven't heard of the Aritzia Connor coat before, it's a very interesting coat. When I first saw it, I didn't like it very much, to be honest. It has this interesting collar situation with like these lines, these seams, which create this line effect. And I didn't like that. I thought it kind of looked like medieval armor. Anyway, this autumn of 2020, I became a little bit obsessed with finding the perfect wool coat. Obsessed in a good way, though, you know, like just something to think about in the background or, you know, something to search for in the shops. And I did. I did search. I searched probably most of the retail stores that sell coats in downtown Montreal and a lot of websites. I looked through a lot of websites. And I found that there's kind of a market gap between like the 150, 250 wool blend coats, and then the like $900 to like $1,500 100% wool cashmere blend, like creme de la creme coats. There was just like a segment missing in between where I didn't really want a poly blend, but I also didn't want to spend, you know, over $1,000 on a non-goose down coat. So that made me revisit the Connor coat because it's actually a really good bang for buck item in my opinion because the price point is very accessible, but it's 100% wool, which is quite hard to find for like under $500. So I went in stores and I actually tried the coat on. And once I had it on, I actually kind of liked the collar because it's so warm. Like you just have this convertible scarf. Anyway, so I realized that I actually really liked it from a style and function perspective. Then Black Friday happened and it went on sale. And so I decided to order it in an extra, extra small in the long version in black. Unfortunately, that did not work for me. I kind of fluctuate in Aritzia sizes between an extra, extra small, an extra small, a small. Yeah, those are like the three sizes that I fluctuate between. And I thought that because it was a coat and I have the little puffer in extra, extra small, that the extra, extra small Connor coat would fit me well as well. But it didn't. It didn't even button, actually. It fit me everywhere just fine, except it just didn't close on the bust. So I ended up actually getting the caramel color and in the short version as opposed to the long version. I still love the long version. I just found that the material was a bit stiffer, so if I wanted to be able to squeeze into an extra small, I could do it in the short version, but I couldn't in the long version. And in the long version, I would have had to get a small, which would have then been too big on my shoulders. So the stars aligned, got the camel, got the extra small, fits like a glove. I think all in it was about $400, which is super reasonable for a 100% wool coat that has such gorgeous detailing and structure. 3 months after the purchase, I'm still quite impressed by the quality for the price. So there's this really nice satin lining within the whole coat, which is an absolute must for me because I do live in a colder climate region. The lining makes the coat so much warmer. What do you guys think about this tag? I've seen people on the street with it, I've seen them without it. I don't know whether or not to remove it. It doesn't really bother me, but at the same time, like, does it look stupid to just have the tag left on? Please let me know in the comments whether or not I should take that off. So the main things that I really love about this coat are the quality, both of the material and of the craftsmanship. The details on this are really gorgeous, and the material itself is super soft and pretty warm. The fit, I think the fit is very flattering. It's classic, and I like the fitted aspect. Right now, there's this huge trend with oversized coats, and I really love it. But in terms of a piece that I can invest in that I will enjoy for many, many years, I tend to like clothing that is more fitted. So knowing that and knowing myself and my own style, I wanted to invest in more of a fitted coat than the gorgeous, albeit oversized coats that are out there right now. What do you think? Do you prefer oversized coats or more of the fitted look as well? And finally, I love the versatility of this coat. There are actually several different ways you can wear it. The first way is just open, which is obviously not doable on colder days, but you know, in between seasons, it's totally doable. The second way is with the buttons undone, with just the waist tie fastening the coat. Then you can do up the buttons and do the sash. And finally, you can do up the buttons, do up the sash, and then pop up the collar to have the infamous scarf collar, as I call it, which is the warmest way of wearing it. It's honestly so good. Like, imagine you go out for dinner and you've got the collar down and then you leave the restaurant and all of a sudden it's like 5, 6, 7 degrees colder. And now you've got a scarf. I think that covers it. If you have any questions, if there's something that I did not cover, then please leave them in the comments down below. I would love to hear from you. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.